Jumping to conclusions is another thing we never really want to do. It's another negative thing. Jumping to conclusions kind of means we assume something that happened without having all the information already. The first example I always think of is a relationship between, let's say, a boyfriend and a girlfriend, okay? The boyfriend is out one day and he's walking with another girl, not his girlfriend. Then his girlfriend sees him from far away and he's like, oh my gosh, my boyfriend is cheating on me. She's jumping to conclusions because she saw another girl, so she automatically thinks that he's cheating on her. In reality, maybe it's his mom or his sister or just a friend. Okay, so she doesn't have all the information, so she's jumping to conclusions. Some similar expressions would be to like misjudge something, to have an uneducated guess about something, or even to jump the gun. When we say jump the gun, it means we start too early. Starting too early before we know everything, before we're ready for something.
Don't jump the gun if you get a job offer. Don't jump the gun if you get a job offer. Don't jump the gun if you get a job offer.
Any final words?
When you start studying English, don't jump to conclusions about how hard it is to learn. Just keep working, keep trying, and I guarantee you guys are going to be able to speak English fluently sooner or later.
English. 자, 오늘 준비한 표현, jump to conclusions라는 표현입니다. jump라는 것은 점프하는 거죠. conclusions가 있는데, conclusions로 점프를 하는 겁니다. 결론으로 바로 가는 것을 생각해 보시면 돼요. 우리가 어떤 결론을 내릴 때 여러 가지 증거를 잡고 나서 그런 다음에 결론을 내리는 거지 뭐 하나 그냥 보고 결론을 내릴 수는 없는 거잖아요. 그렇죠? 가장 대표적인 어떠한 예는 남녀관계 사용할 수 있다고 하는데요. 예를 들어서 제가 여자친구가 있다고 생각해 볼게요. 근데 여자친구가 다른 남자하고 같이 있는 걸 봤을 때 너 걔 누구야? 너 걔 저기 사귀는 사람이지? 이렇게 한다는 것은 결국은 어때요? 그냥 하나 보고 나서 그걸 가지고 결론을 내리는 거잖아요. 그렇죠? 아닐 경우도 있잖아요. 그렇죠? 그래서 항상 어떤 일을 할 때는요. 그냥 생각 없이 그냥 그러니까 그렇지! Jump to conclusion 하면요. 오히려 더 큰 문제가 생길 수 있다는 거 꼭 기억하시기 바랍니다. 그리고 하나만 더 추가할 표현은요. Jump the gun 이라는 표현인데요. Jump the gun 같은 경우는 달리기에서 나온 표현입니다. 달리기를 할 때 자, 심판이요. Ready? 그 다음에 그 총을 올리잖아요. 그쵸? 건을 올리잖아요. 그쵸? 그러면 그 전에 출발하는 사람이 있단 말이죠. 총을 올리기 전에. 그래서 jump the gun이라는 표현 같은 경우는 어떤 것을 생각하지 않고 바로 미리 뭘 하는 사람 있잖아요. 준비 없이 하는 사람. 그런 사람을 묘사할 때 우리가 jump the gun이라는 표현도 사용할 수 있다고 합니다.
Something's happened to Giles, I know it.
Let's not jump to any conclusions.
Something's happened to Giles, I know it.
Let's not jump to any conclusions.
Something's happened to Giles, I know it.
Let's not jump to any conclusions.
Something's happened to Giles, I know it.
Let's not jump to any conclusions.
Something's happened to Giles, I know it.
Let's not jump to any conclusions.
While we should never jump to conclusions based on one story alone, it seems this is a tale that demands some investigation. While we should never jump to conclusions based on one story alone, it seems this is a tale that demands some investigation. While we should never jump to conclusions based on one story alone, it seems this is a tale that demands some investigation. While we should never jump to conclusions based on one story alone, it seems this is a tale that demands some investigation. While we should never jump to conclusions based on one story alone, it seems this is a tale that demands some investigation.
Hold your horses. Count to 10. Take a deep breath. Don't jump to conclusions. You don't know what she's doing on her iPhone, so just relax. Hold your horses. Count to 10. Take a deep breath. Don't jump to conclusions. You don't know what she's doing on her iPhone, so just relax. Hold your horses. Count to 10. Take a deep breath. Don't jump to conclusions. You don't know what she's doing on her iPhone, so just relax. Hold your horses. Count to 10. Take a deep breath. Don't jump to conclusions. You don't know what she's doing on her iPhone, so just relax.
자, 오늘 표현 jump to conclusions 꼭 기억하고 넘어가시고요. 우리 그럼 다음 시간에 또 뵙도록 하겠습니다. See you guys next time. Bye bye.